Hey, Dirt Farmer Jay here from DirtFarmerJay.com. Recently, we purchased this 20-volt cordless blower from DeWalt, their DCBL722 model. Now, this little blower is pretty compact. We're gonna walk you through how it performs, the unboxing, and 1 year from now, we'll come back and show you how we like it after one full year of use. Stay tuned, and I'll walk you through it. Hey, Dirt Farmer Jay from DirtFarmerJay.com. We recently added this little cordless blower to our repertoire of DeWalt tools, all using this kind of battery pack. Works really well because we already have all the charging stations and other compatible tools. And we have some initial impressions about this unit and some ways to use it. We're going to walk you through the unboxing in just a moment. But before we do that, just a couple things. One, always there will be more information that we can do in a video and make it short enough that it remains interesting. There's always going to be more information in the description below, such as specifications, tips that we got from the tech line from DeWalt and so forth. So be sure that you check that out. And when it's time to do that 1 year review, there'll also be that link down below that you can just click right over there and see how we feel about this unit 12 months from now. Well, let's begin with the unboxing. We bought this unit, the bare tool, meaning no battery pack, so the battery was not with it, and it was just what you see here, the concentrator on the tip, the blower tube, and the handle and the fan unit, all in one box. And as you can see here, it came nicely packaged. When you open it up, you essentially get those three pieces plus a little bit of documentation, and you can see that goes in our file for future reference, and also to register it, which I always do with my tools, so if there's a warranty issue, I can get it fixed. So that was all done. Now, when it comes time to put it together, we're just going to have Dirt Farmer Maggie here show you how she put this together. The first thing you're going to do is you need to put the concentrator tip on. And if you note, it kind of looks like a jet engine tip, but that needs to be snapped into place. And then you tug on it to make sure it's there, set it in very well with the securement tabs. The next thing that happens then, the blower tube itself needs to get aligned and put into the body of the fan. But please notice here, as she's demonstrating, that there is a indentation on the side of the blower unit where a screwdriver or a lever of some kind is inserted in the side, which allows you to unlatch this in the future. It's a little bit stubborn, but we want to show you how it works. Here you can see as she levers the screwdriver, you can see the inside latch. Then there is an alignment on the tube itself here. There's a tab that aligns with a groove in the bottom of the unit right here. And so that needs to get slid in and then secured. And once you put those together, you're done. Except now you see that we need to put on a battery. And the battery just clips in the usual way that all the DeWalt ones do. They slide in with a protected terminals, and then there is a securement device that holds the battery in place and does well. Now, as far as battery life, how long these last? Well, I had two different online conversations with DeWalt, and frankly, they weren't that helpful. The information that they gave was pretty doggone general. And what I was asking them about was the average runtime for a 5 amp hour battery like what we have here. As a matter of fact, I said the common battery size you're going to see out there is probably 4, 5, 6. How long would the average user, if they're running this at full blast, how long would that battery last? Well, they were pretty vague, citing all sorts of different reasons: temperature, age of the unit, how old the battery is, whether it's run at full throttle or partial throttle, and all that. And I understood that. I'd asked for a range. When pressed for more information, they gave an answer of, depending on the battery, you're probably going to get 10 to 20 minutes of run at full throttle. And that is certainly in line with our experience. We found running this one day, we got about 17, 18 minutes full blast before the battery said enough and the unit shut down. We just swapped out the battery, put it on the charger, and continued with our work. But I want to give you a little tip here that you might find helpful. You don't need to run the machine. I'm going to turn it on full blast like that the entire time. It's not necessary. You can run it partial and it puts out a surprising amount of air at the other end. As a matter of fact, I actually recommend that you run this about 50 to 70% throttle. The reason for that is the stream of air coming out of the concentrator can be so strong and so directed, you get back blast. That is, let's suppose you're blowing leaves and they tend to do a circular motion and come back and land back behind you, even as you're sweeping left or right. So slow it down a little bit and let the leaves get caught in that draft of wind and run away. Now, if you need to run it at a higher speed to get something stubborn or cleaning out gutters or that sort of thing, it'll work very well. There's another thing you should know on here that's a nice little feature I think DeWalt designed here, and that is, for lack of a better term, a cruise control. So if you look at the top right here, you can see this right here. It works in concert with the throttle down here, but it's somewhat independent. I know that's a little confusing. Let me show you what I mean. I can run this unit by pulling it like this, and I can actually run it very softly right there. And if I wanted to set that at that speed, I can simply slide with this. Notice I'm not pulling the bottom, I'm pushing the top. And whatever I push that top to, it's going to stay at that speed. Well, I could use that, let's say at 50% or so, just to move lightweight items in front of me. And when I need burst, I can just do that and it'll return back to where it was. Pretty handy. And it saves battery life, makes the job easier as well. Nice thought out feature there. Little easier to hear now. Now let's talk about the blower itself. You can't see it in here, but you can guess by the shape of the unit itself that we have a flat fan that is somewhat like, whenever you've looked at a jet engine, you can see an axial fan with blades that are going around like this. And it's called axial because the axis in which that fan rotates is the same direction as the air is being moved. So you have a flat fan here, pulling in, ingesting a very high volume of air, concentrating it through here and through a concentrator at the tip to produce some high velocity air that really can move the leaves and such. In contrast to an axial fan, you may have seen another type that's used for bigger units, for air movers, but would not work in this size package. For you geeks out there, that's a centrifugal fan. And a centrifugal fan is the kind that you see, let's say when you're exiting out a car wash and they've got those moving blowers. We've got this round unit with a motor going off perpendicular to the fan direction or the air direction. That's a centrifugal blower. Squirrel cages that you find in evaporative coolers are a type of centrifugal blower. So they move a lot of air, can exchange a lot of air, but they're not as compact. So this does a great job, more like the jet turbine type of setup. We found one of the greatest uses for this around here is cleaning out our garage. And as you can see here, leaves collect quite a bit under our car and truck, and they're a real nuisance. You have to back things out, sweep it out, and all that. Well, not anymore. Since getting this, I can simply stand at the nose of both vehicles or along the sides and blow the air under it, propelling the leaves out onto the apron, lowering the door down, and then doing the rest of the apron and sidewalk in here. Now here you can see Dirt Farmer Maggie using it in a couple ways. One is actually moving leaves, dry leaves, right off the surface of the lawn, which is really handy when you want to dress up an area, you're setting up something for a social gathering or dolling up an area. This really works very nicely. Also, just for general cleaning of an area like an apron of a garage or a driveway, you can simply, by using an arcing motion left and right, push everything in front of you and get it out of the way. And it's especially handy for cleaning off sidewalks that have got leaves all over it. Or even if there's standing water there that you want to get off, there's pockets that, this will do a great job. And as I mentioned earlier, it has plenty of power for blowing out leaves out of gutters. Okay, let's give you some specifications here. This is capable with a concentrator producing flow of up to 125 miles an hour. You heard that right. So you can really move some debris. That's why I said you can throttle back and still get some great results and better runtime when you do that. As far as the cubic feet per minute, it's rated at 450 cubic feet per minute, or CFM. Weight is almost about 8 pounds, 7.7 pounds. When you add a battery, you're going to land well under 10. The unit seems to be well balanced when you hold it here at the center. It looks pretty balanced. If I grab it right there, it hangs straight with that battery in it. And when I grab it here, it runs downhill just a little bit, which is the natural position you most likely be walking with it anyway. So I think that works really well. Now, lastly, what about the sound level on this? Well, it runs about 64 to 66 decibels. So it's a moderate level, but it's not anything like one of the gas ones. So if you're in a neighborhood where you need to run things quietly, or there's ordinances that won't allow two-stroke motors, this is your salvation. Well, we think it's such a valuable unit that we've actually given it a place in the home. Let me show you what I mean. The bottom line, we like this little blower so much that we're giving it a home in our mudroom, along with the other home maintenance items here, including the Dyson vac we have here with its charging base. We've gone ahead and built this little project right here, which we'll show in a future video. You can find the link to it in the description below when it's published. And we'll change the end card at the end of this video when that episode is done. And you can see how we built that, where we've got this bracket, how the keyhole slots, how to mount it, and all those sort of things. And we just used the closest yellow paint that we could get that would match the DeWalt color. Pretty doggone good match to give it a really nice home here. And this bracket just allows you to take this, hang it right up here, securely on the wall here. You can take out the battery right here and simply hang it right there. And for those of you who are curious, can you overcharge the battery? No. DeWalt has told us that through the technical support department, that these chargers are designed to keep a maintenance charge going without fatiguing the battery. So you're in good shape there. If you found this video to be helpful, won't you like it? And better yet, subscribe to our channel. And when you do, ring the bell. That way you'll be notified of great video content approximately every Friday on the home, the garden, the kitchen. Great products like this, and products that maybe sometimes aren't so good, that inform you about how to just do it yourself. And while you're at it, check out our website at dirtfarmerj.com for extended content, as well as great merchandise, hats, shirts, coffee mugs. It's a great way to let other people know that you just do it yourself. Until the next time, this is Dirt Farmer Jay from dirtfarmerj.com.